This tutorial video about a beer tray shows you how to create 2D toolpath using the free edition of the DeskProto CAM software. The beer tray is a free sample drawing. So let's start DeskProto to see how we can generate the toolpath for this beer tray. The first dialog that you see is the edition select dialog. It now says free edition, and the three paid editions are available in trial mode. That means that when you create toolpath, the resulting part will show a watermark indicating trial mode. However, we do not want the trial mark on our beer tray, so we'll start the free edition. Three different task groups in the start screen. Recent projects, when you just started DeskProto, obviously this still could be empty. Other tasks include sample projects and support stuff. We want to do a new project. I check use samples folder, as there the beer tray sample geometry is located, and I select start the wizard. Okay, check if your milling machine has been selected in this long list of machines. We start the basic vector machining wizard, as the beer tray has been defined in vector curves in a two-dimensional drawing. Next. First thing to do is load the CAD data file. We browse and it automatically will open the samples folder. We use the metric version of the file for inch users. An inch version is present as well. Open the file. Here we are. Here is the beer tray geometry. Well, what can we do? We can scale, but we do not want to scale, as the size of the holes would be incorrect for beer glasses or for coffee cups. A rotation is not needed as well. On our machine, the long axis, as you can see down here, the long axis is the x-axis, so no rotation is needed. The only thing I need to change is the z settings. The slab of material that we have, it's some plywood board, is 6 millimeters thick. We want to machine it in one go, so we need to set the machining depth to minus 6 millimeters, 6 millimeters below the top of the block. Okay, next we go to the block. It has been drawn here already. Default thickness is 10 millimeters. Well, as said, our plywood is 6 millimeters, so I'll change that to 6. And I also want to make X and Y a bit larger, as I want to complete, I want all separate pieces of plywood to be attached to the machining table during the complete process. So if the block is a bit larger, that's much easier. So here we are. 400 by 250 by 6, which in inches will about be 16 inches by 10 inches and a quarter of inch thick. Okay, next, the actual cutting parameters. We need a cutter with a flat tip. 6 millimeter diameter is okay, so a quarter of an inch. The feed rate for plywood, well, machining 6 millimeter in one go is heavy duty, so make the feed rate a bit smaller. And for wood, generally a high spindle speed is needed, so I'll make these changes. The profiling strategy on the outside is okay. I want to machine the outside of this beer tray curve, and DeskProto is sufficiently intelligent to realize that for the holes. Then the inside needs to be machined. Default support tabs, and let's see, calculate button, what happens. It starts calculating, and here we are. You can see here the support tabs, where the cutter rises a bit to keep both sides of the groove connected. The only thing is that I see all holes only have one support tab, which is a bit too limited. I want two, so I'll change that to custom. and add by simply clicking an extra support tab for each hole. And here's number 7. Okay, again, calculate. And here we are, 2 support tabs for each hole. And well, this is the toolpath that I need. Here it's on the outside, here's on the inside. It starts at the downward arrow and it ends here at the upward arrow. You also see the zero point here. So on the machine, we'll need to make sure that here on the corner we set the zero point. Last thing to mention is the estimated machining time. DeskProto estimates it will cost about 8 minutes to machine this complete part. Okay, next. Well, the toolpaths are already shown, so nothing new here. What I can add is a simulation. Here we are. You nicely see the effect of a support tab and also the complete result as it will be after machining. Okay, no need to keep that in place, height. And the final step is writing the NC program. We'll call it beer tray. So here we are in the samples folder. Keep that in mind as we want to pick it up there later. And now I can say finish, which concludes the DeskProto part of this demonstration. As you can see, we are now at the machine. All has been set to start machining. A few details I want to show you. Here below our piece of plywood, you see this extra board. This is the waste board, which will protect the machining table when the cutter goes a bit below the bottom of the block. 4 clamps at the corners, making sure that the cutter won't come any near one of the clamps while cutting. The cutter is a special cutter for wood, as standard cutters for metal tend to become far too hot when machining in wood. And finally, we have set the zero point on the machine with the cutter here on the corner of the slab of material, with the tip of the cutter touching the top of the block. And now we're all set to start machining.